Recently, the President of the United States, Donald J. Trump, and the First Lady, Melania, tested positive for the novel coronavirus. Since testing positive, it seems like the President's condition has declined rapidly, while simultaneously the timeline of who he may have interacted with has been exposed, and as always, we're about to break it all down for you right here on IO. Welcome back to Inform Overload, I'm your host and Bacon King, Johnny Rogers, and you're watching the number one tea spilling entertainment news show on the internet. Before we kick this video off though, if you want to see what your favorite influencer has been up to lately, just tap that playlist in the corner of your screen. Also, if you want to get notified whenever we post new content, you gotta smash that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. Now, without further delay, let's get right into today's story. A decision to move President Trump to a military hospital on Friday was made after his symptoms began to seriously take a turn for the worst. Trump was transferred to the Walter Reed National Military Medical Center after his doctor decided he needed to be kept under close observation in case they needed to quickly administer oxygen and other therapies if required. Helen Boucher, the chief of infectious diseases at Tufts Medical Center in Boston, confirmed this move by saying, "The reason someone would go to the hospital would include closer observation, oxygen therapy, and perhaps consideration of other therapies." The White House doctor Sean Conley released a statement late on Friday and said that the doctors have begun giving Trump an antiviral medication that has shown some modest benefits for most of their patients. Some other treatments that are being considered range from a steroid that could help breathing issues as well as blood thinners to prevent any clotting. It seems like the president's condition has depleted in a matter of moments. On Friday, the White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows had described Trump's symptoms as mild, but by that evening, two people familiar with the president's condition said that he now had a low-grade fever, a cough, and nasal congestion, among other symptoms. What will now be critical is the monitoring of his heart rate, the level of oxygen, as well as his respiratory rate and blood pressure since being diagnosed. The trends that can be viewed from those test results will be critical in determining what to do next for his treatment. The doctors at Walter Reed have taken care of enough patients at this point to understand when a patient is not doing well. In some COVID-19 patients, their symptoms can turn severe in just a few short hours, and especially if they are near the second week of the illness. Not to mention those risk factors that I mentioned in my previous video where we announced his initial test results. The interesting thing is that Trump is also going to be a case study for an experimental therapy drug that is still being evaluated in a late-stage clinical trial for both the treatment and prevention of COVID-19. That being said, the doctors involved with Trump refused to comment on whether or not Melania would also be receiving the same treatment. Now, by Sunday, Trump was able to leave the Walter Reed Medical Center in Maryland, but here's where Trump really got himself into some trouble. As he was being driven in the back of a black SUV, Trump was greeted by a crowd of people waving at him, many of which were holding Trump 2020 banners and MAGA signs. Dr. James Phillips, the chief of disaster medicine at George Washington University and a physician at Walter Reed Medical, slammed the president on Twitter for actions that he called insanity. Dr. Phillips tweeted, "That presidential SUV is not only bulletproof, but hermetically sealed against chemical attack. The risk of COVID-19 transmission inside is as high as it gets outside of medical procedures. The irresponsibility is astounding. My thoughts are with the Secret Service forced to play." I mean, he's got a point. Every single person in that vehicle with him that decided to do this unnecessary presidential drive-by has to now be quarantined for 14 days. They could get sick, they could even die, and for what? Political theater? It's honestly really disheartening to see so many politicians put others in harm's way so that they can snag an extra few votes. Many are saying that Trump shouldn't have even left the hospital if his condition had worsened since arriving, although I suppose it really is up to the doctors there to decide if he was fit for going home. The fact that he had to do another parade drive-by though was just a little ridiculous. White House spokesperson Judd Deere did hit back at critics saying that the brief trip had been cleared by the medical team as safe to do. But we want to hear your thoughts on this story though, so comment down below if you think that this will force Trump to take COVID more seriously, or do you feel otherwise? Either way, we want to know down in those comments down below. And while you ponder that, let's check out some of your comments from the video titled "Jeffree Star's Boyfriend Has Robbed Him, Allegedly." Jomana says, "Why don't these adults keep their feuds private rather than plaster them all over social media? Look, you're taking the words straight out of my mouth. I can't believe some of the antics that these adults are getting up to. Makes my life seem boring." Wildfire says, "Now he's going to feel justified in his closeted racism." Yikes. I mean, let's hope not. If he felt justified, that doesn't mean that it's justified, and who's to say that he's not faking the whole thing? I guess we'll keep an eye on it. Alexia says, "Is this the same one that defended JS, or is this a different boyfriend?" I honestly have lost track entirely, so someone please let me know in those comments. Melinda says, "The jokes just write themselves this week." Oh, you got that right, Melinda. There were almost too many to make. Angel Sunshine says, could JS have dated him because he's black? You know, to dispel the racist rumors? Just a thought. If that's the case, he's not doing himself any favors by accusing people of stealing his things. Just a really weird scenario if that was his motif going into the relationship. But it's Jeffree Star, so who knows. Thank you for watching our trending news segment, and thank you to the most amazing team behind the scenes for all of their hard work. If you enjoyed this video, then please show us some love here by tapping that like and subscribe button. Plus, don't forget to leave this comment down below with your thoughts on today's story. And for more videos like this one, all you gotta do is click that playlist when it pops up. From Inform Overload, my name is Johnny Rogers, and until next time, stay classy. Thank you for watching today's trending news segment, and thank you to the most amazing teams for... Let's do that again. Okay. And thank. Getting it all over the bloopers. Now we're doing the outro.